Anniversary Digitally Remastered Edition of the Octagon.
No one will admit they still exist.
Does anyone really know?
Efficient killers who work in silence, secrecy, darkness, unholy masters of terror by magic. The man he once called brother is now his deadly enemy. He must find the strength to become everything he hates.
I wanted you because you could succeed.
I need your help.
The professional who wants targets.
If you saw ninjas, you've seen ghosts.
An heiress who wants revenge.
I want to know who they are.
I know who they are.
Everybody wants something from him. A prisoner of his own destiny. He will find freedom only one way.
Don't torment me anymore, Sakura.
Chuck Norris, Karen Carlson, Lee Van Cleef, The Octagon.
The Octagon is an action drama thriller movie that was released on August 15th, 1980. It has been a while, but we are talking about another Chuck Norris movie. Is this an enjoyable entry in his filmography? Well, let's find out by starting with a story. The story follows a martial artist named Scott James, who finds that his childhood friend, Sakura, might be behind a plot to create ninja terrorists in a camp. It all stemmed from the fact that there have been mysterious killings with ninja weapons and being involved. Apparently, this whole crime ring for making ninja terrorists is called the Octagon. Overall, I think this story is actually pretty fucking good. It starts off as more of a drama thriller with a huge mystery, but evolves into an action movie eventually. The way it did it makes me think that both angles seem to melt into each other very well. And that may have to do with the fact that both of these styles actually have a lot in common if you really fucking think about it. Is that all I have to say about the story? Hell no. Another thing that I like about it is the fact that there is a rich heiress character that is not actually evil. Although you might think she is at the beginning. She constantly tries to convince Scott to help her with something that is not given much explanation. This leads Scott to believe that the heiress is actually hiding something sinister. And in fact, he even tries to have her spit out what she is hiding numerous times. Even after she says she's not trying to fuck with Scott with some evil plot. I'm going to get into spoiler territory, but this is really important. The heiress actually gets killed by one of the ninjas. This, in a way, almost proves that she was not hiding anything. It is fucking amazing that the movie took that direction. Because it ultimately says that not all rich people are evil, and makes a case of why sometimes you should not believe, what people are saying. Because they might not actually be lying. You could interpret Scott also regretting being so mistrustful of the heiress. They could have easily done another story about how evil rich people are, but that is not really what this ended up as. I honestly cannot think of any other fucking movie that took this approach. I guess if there's anything that I don't like about the story is the fact that either Scott or a wise mentor of some kind tells him not to go after Sakura. If it was Scott, then it makes no goddamn sense unless he thought he could redeem Sakura. But Scott does keep going after Sakura, making it goddamn pointless. Although you could interpret it as Scott realizing that Sakura can't be fixed at this point. If it was a wise mentor, well, apparently he does not realize what Sakura is doing and what he's become. Either way, the line of dialogue was unnecessary and to be honest, pretty contrived. If it was cut out, or hell, if it was rewritten to encourage Scott, then it would actually be better. You could still make it vague, too. Well, as vague as they made it. Okay, this is the last thing I will mention about the story. I felt that the romantic subplot between Scott and Nancy was okay. It does not really appear until later in the story. While it does not have much time to grow, I think it is acceptable because at this point, the heiress is dead and Nancy does have some vital information. The sex scene between them is decent as well. It is not really that shocking considering a fair amount of Chuck Norris movies have scenes like this. But every Chuck Norris movie, at least the action movies, have action scenes of some sort. And I have to say, the action scenes are pretty fucking good. And I have to say, the action scenes are pretty fucking good. They're not as good as Lone Wolf McQuaid or The Delta Force, but they're still pretty goddamn satisfying. There are mostly fight scenes, which include punches and the roundhouse kick a few times. There is also use of swords sometimes. But in addition to that, there is brief use of guns and an explosion or two, most of which are caused by other heroic characters, including Nancy. And I guess it's also fun to see the dumb rowdy bastards get what they deserve. It is all filmed and edited very neatly, like it should be. Well, for the most part, or the beginning of the action, of the final action scene might be a little too dark to make everything out, but it does improve later, and maybe rewatching it does help it a little better. Rewatching it helps you see it better. That's, yeah. As for the production values, the cinematography is pretty good, as well as the editing. The sound is a bit better on Blu-ray, but it might not sound that great on older technology. But the music is pretty forgettable. But overall, The Octagon is a pretty fucking solid Chuck Norris movie, with a pretty good story, great action scenes, and it is filmed and edited pretty well. The flaws that I found are that the screenplay could have used maybe a few minor rewrites, and I will say, if you don't like B-movies, you probably won't enjoy this one. But for those who are fine with B-movies, and especially if you like Chuck Norris movies, I think you'll actually enjoy this one a lot. I gave The Octagon 4 out of 5 stars, with the title of Awesome. Anyway, I'm Spike Robot. Thank you. If you like this video, you can subscribe to my channel, and see you next time.